Hi and welcome back to another Logic Pro episode. Today we're going to look at how to sync your external hardware synth to a Logic Pro. You're going to learn how to set up an external hardware instrument in Logic Pro, do the correct cable connections with your hardware synth and your audio interface or computer, and also how to do the syncing of the MIDI clock from your DAW to the synth. Let's take the tour. Right, so the synth I'm using today is the Unisynth Pro X, but basically you can use any type of synthesizer that has either MIDI or MIDI over USB. Keep in mind that if you want to connect the synth that has these MIDI DIN ports, you also need to have a MIDI interface with the DIN ports. But luckily most of today's synths feature a USB port or a USB-C port, which supports the MIDI protocol. So in this example, we're going to use the USB-C port to send and receive the MIDI from our computer. So our first connection is the USB-C cable to the synth, and then we connect the other end to our computer. Right, so that will give us MIDI over USB-C. The next step is to connect the audio from the synth to your audio interface. So we're gonna use the main output ports left and right from the synth and connect the other ends to our audio interface. And for that I'm using these telecables. Like so. Right, so we're done with all the connections and the cabling, so now the next step is to go into Logic here and configure our hardware instrument. Let's begin by creating a new instrument track, or a new software instrument track. Now we'll replace the electric piano with our external instrument. So press to the right side here, go down to Utility, and select External Instrument, Stereo. Now if our computer recognizes the MIDI over USB, we're gonna be able to select the MIDI destination to Unisynth Pro X in this case. And we can let the MIDI channel be all and select the audio inputs. And in my case, I think it's 13 to 14. But in your case, it might be 1 or 2, depending on what kind of audio inputs you used on your audio interface. So now we should be able to hear and also control the synth from Logic Pro. So let's try that out. Let's move some MIDI to our new hardware track. I also want to use an arpeggiator on this track. So let's go into the MIDI effects and select arpeggiator. And that will arpeggiate these long sustained notes that we have on in the MIDI region. And now we can basically also use the internal effects of Logic Pro. So let's remove the reverb that we have on the synth. And let's bump the sound effects here in. Now, if you want, you can also record the automations that you do on the synth in Logic Pro. Let's activate record and record some automation. Right, so that's basically everything you need to do to get the MIDI from your sequencer, Logic Pro in this case, into your hardware synth. Now, if you also want to sync the arpeggiator on board of the synth with Logic Pro, there's a few other steps. We need to activate the MIDI sync. And to do that, we go into Product Settings and Synchronization. And we go to the MIDI tab. And here we need to activate a destination. So select the Unisynth Pro X as the destination and activate clock. Now, if your synth is set to receive a MIDI synchronization, if we play Logic Sequencer, it should also trigger and play the arpeggiator on the synth. So let's try that. yes, that's basically everything you need to do to set up an external hardware synth to work properly with the Logic Pro. Now, if you like my content here on YouTube, please consider joining my Logic Pro for Beginners course, where you will learn everything you need to know to work with Logic Pro X efficiently. Please let me know in the comments if you have any questions, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm Mattias, have a great Christmas, bye!